the 510. DJ Breezel. 24/7.
90s mix, the Kobe mix. 90s, the 97s. DJ Nice, DJ Breeze, KJCC Live.
R.I.P. to Kobe.
DJ Breeze in the mix here. This is our Kobe mix. Fitting that 90s theme, that's why we're going back to that 90s theme. Doing your thing over there, Breeze. DJ Nice and DJ Breeze, KJCC Live. Kobe mix. Put together this 90s mix, man.
I'm throwing it together as I go right now. I've been humble over this past couple of days with Kobe being gone.
Right,
you know?
Right.
A lot on my mind right now.
Yeah, so how did that affect you, man?
Well, basically, the way I look at it, I'm thinking about, I put myself inside the helicopter, like, what was his thoughts? And he's helpless and he can't do anything for his daughter as the helicopter's going down. I feel his pain and, you know, it's just really a sad situation that transpired. When I first seen it on Facebook, I was hoping it was just a lie or something, you know, like
right,
the way it was on Facebook.
Right.
But it was very truthful. And, you know, a lot of other people lost their lives on that.
Right.
You know, and
absolutely.
That too. It's just really sad. But, you know, after doing further research into it, found out that the pilot shouldn't have been flying that helicopter anyway in that type of weather conditions. There's a special module that he's supposed to have on that helicopter that was recommended to him that he didn't get. So... I don't know if Kobe was aware of that, but you know, the pilot shouldn't have been flying that helicopter in that fog, period.
You know, Breeze, let's go back to Leah's situation again. A pilot making a bad decision
once again. Yep, that's another decision where the plane was overloaded, and that's why Leah's not here with us right now. The plane was overloaded, and you know, she didn't even want to take certain things. She didn't want to go certain things. You know, and you know, that's the scary thing about certain artists. When you know artists that didn't want to do things or go places. Like the Vegas night with Tupac, you know, he wasn't wearing his vest and he didn't even want to really go to the fight.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I'm just like, you know,
destiny.
Sometimes people can see a reason why they don't want to go a certain route, but they don't know why.
Right. I guess that's sometimes you kind of got to go with your hunch or your... Go with like a mother. A mother always knows. To put this in perspective, a mother always knows. I was having a beautiful dinner with my mother last night. Thank you, Mommy Raider Pucci. Beautiful. So she made me, my mother made me some chicken a la king, and we were talking about how Kobe's wife and they made a pact that they would never ride on a plane or a helicopter together. So, for them to have that pact, it shows you that they didn't want to never leave those kids alone. So, thinking like that, man, is just, my mom told me that last night. I've been just thinking like, it just brings me chills. Well, me and Breeze, we're here to lift you guys up. This is the Kobe mix, the 97 mix. So, the 90s mix, I'm sorry. And we're going to do the best to lift you guys up. Here,
would
DJ.
You say the 97 mix?
Well, because Kobe came out in 97.
Yeah.
So most of these songs they're from the 90s.
Right, this is basically all 90s. So yeah,
all 90s.
We're going to boost your spirits up now. We talked about Kobe. May he rest in paradise.
Rest in paradise.
Like I said, it went from what, Michael Jordan to Kobe to LeBron. You know what I'm saying? All the greatest. You know what I'm saying? The torch has been passed.
And then to go further into how you said the torch was passed. The day that Kobe... gave LeBron congratulations the day before that.
Yeah, the day before that.
That just gives me too much chills.
LeBron will never forget that for the rest of his life.
You think?
You know?
That's heavy, man. You know, guys, if you're any kind of athlete, any kind of anything, and you need some drive, There it is right there.
Yes, sir.
Let's jump into this mix, DJ Breeze. Let's do what we do best.
Let's bring our spirits up. Come on, why? Let's bring your spirits up right now.
DJ Nice, DJ Breeze.
And we love you, Kobe.
We love you, brother. We will never forget you. KJCC Live. Go 49ers, go, go. Bang, bang, bang. Go 49ers, do your thang, thang, thang. If you a 49er fan, do your thong, go, go, red, gold, then thang. Go 49ers, bang, bang, bang.
Perfect.
Thanks, Reed. Okay, you guys, be careful. If you're out there, there's construction on I-680 northbound south of Mission Boulevard in Fremont. Lanes are blocked. Expected delays. And also, we got here, we got a delays on I-280 northbound. California 85 South Sunnyvale right shoulder is blocked. Expect delays. So take your time, you guys. Seem like these are trouble areas every day, so no surprises, right? And also, let's see. So far, look like that's it. We'll check back here with a minute. This is DJ Nice, DJ Breeze with the traffic mix. Take your time. Take your time. DJ Breeze, DJ Nice, Traffic Mix, KJCC Live, the student station, 104.111. I was watching Wendy. Man, the Grammys has changed. They don't do the things like they used to. Like, do they still give away gift bags? Like, they used to, when I went, man, they used to give you, now this is back in 94, long time ago. When Whitney Houston won I Would Always Love You. Man, they gave me, when I got to the Grammys, they gave me a big old bag of CD disc players and T-shirts and all kind of stuff. Now I think they do, they give you home entertainment systems, vacations.
They can give me some money, give me some food, you know what I'm saying?
No, that's the thing. You know, when we go to these events, you know, the Grammys,
as long as they don't give me a chicken's Popeye sandwich, okay? As long as they don't give me that, I'm not eating that at all, bruh.
What's wrong with Popeye sandwich?
Man, what are you talking about, man? You didn't do research on that?
No.
My name should have been Mr. Research. There's like, out of like 43 chemicals, like 32 of them were man-made chemicals. So, I don't know.
Popeye's chicken?
Yeah, Popeye's chicken sandwich. Most of this food out here is so like it's not
real. It's not real.
You need to look it up, bro. I look it up, and that's what I found out. Now, if you look up the ingredients for a Popeye's chicken sandwich, you won't find it nowhere online.
See, I'm not going to Popeye's no more.
First of all, you should be cooking. Okay, you should be cooking your own food. That's what you should be doing. You know what I'm saying? Cook your own food, and if you're not a chef, go get a Rachel Ray book or something. You know what
I'm
saying?
Now you tell me.
Okay.
My mama cooked for me. That chicken out of King was delicious, mama. Is there any more left? What about churches?
Church's chicken?
Yeah, what you hear about them?
I wouldn't. Church's chicken is okay, but I'm not going to comment on church's chicken. Actually, you know the best chicken right now? As you see, I was silent. There really ain't nobody who I say got the best.
That's safe.
There's really nobody right now. I mean, there's a few spots. I think more so the independent and the family-owned places is locking the chicken thing now. Because there's no real, like, I don't eat KFC.
Yeah.
Popeyes, I used to eat, but I don't eat it no more.
Wow.
Church's chicken.
You know what?
It's Church's chicken is good, but sometimes it is, sometimes it's not. You know, different effects.
I was on 73rd yesterday in the town. Why'd I look at Church's chicken? I drove in a circle twice.
Look, I'm not gonna lie.
I just didn't want to take that chance.
About a month ago, we got some Church's chicken. And it took 2 days of recovery.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so I can't eat Church's chicken.
I grew up on that chicken. I grew up on 73rd, so...
Hey,
I was
I cook my own food now. I had to learn how to cook because my kids, they picky. They don't want the same thing. Yeah, you know, what you want to eat? One want Jack in the Box, the other one McDonald's, and they clear across town.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So instead of doing that, I just had to start learning how to cook.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying?
So Amen.
Cooking it up and doing what I do, you know?
Amen.
I'm not no chef boy or deer or nothing.
Yeah.
But I done burned some things. I done burned some grilled cheeses up.
I done burnt the turkey.
Wow, you burnt your turkey. A grilled cheese is hard to burn, though, bro.
Yeah,
you know what I'm
saying?
I burnt grilled cheese.
I done burnt rice, minute rice a couple times.
I done burnt some rice too.
Minute rice? How do you burn minute rice?
Well, you let it burn more than a minute. That's what it was.
DJ Nice here and DJ Breeze, KJCC Live.
Oh, man.
Jumping right back into the traffic mix. I'm going to check out what's going out there and I'll get back to you guys. DJ Breeze, DJ Nice, traffic mix one. You know, I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm going to crash somebody's party. Breeze, we're not booked for anywhere yet, hint, hint. But are you going to, you still got your thing open for Super Bowl? You still open? What you doing?
Well, Super Bowl, normally Super Bowl, I just hang out with my kids. Basically, I don't really do nothing. You know, sometimes I DJ on the Super Bowl. But I found out that when I go to Super Bowl parties, when I DJ Super Bowl parties, I still got to drive home.
Right,
and sometimes I didn't take it a little bit. Too much, you know what I'm saying?
It's better to be smart, right?
I don't want no Uber picking me up with all my DJ equipment, you know what I'm saying? You got room for a couple of 12s, a couple of 15s, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So, I just basically kind of like homebody somewhere. Sometimes I like to be at home, me and the kids barbecue, you know what I'm saying?
I need you safe, so I need
get
you
some drink and eat, you know, and just
Trey, make sure DJ Bree stay at one spot on Sunday if I'm not with y'all.
Now, you know, on Monday, there's going to be a lot of folks calling in sick with all types of my stomach,
my car,
I got this, I got that. So the bosses already know they're going to be calling in because Super Bowl going to have them with their headache, especially in the Bay Area. So, I don't know, be prepared to drink water before you go to bed, take some aspirin, something.
Be smart.
Have Gatorade, drink some Gatorade when you go home, have it by your bed because you're going to wake up at like 4 in the morning, thirsty, dry throat. And then sometimes you might be spinning and you can't walk to the kitchen. So you can just lean over and grab that Gatorade. And you might even want to put a straw in it because it'll go down easier. But that Gatorade, that Red Bull, and that aspirin or Advil, whatever you want to
take. It'll get you over that hump.
It'll get you over that hump. Make sure you eat something too. You know what I'm saying?
Unless you like Jay Nice at the 92 Rose Bowl. When my fraternity met me after I got to the hotel, they met me at the bottom of, now college, I think I was 21 then. But this was celebration after we had just beat Michigan. My fraternity met me at the bottom at the hotel in Hilton in L.A. and gave me a whole half rack. And they said, you must drink every one until we get to the top of the floor. I said, oh, great. So,
man,
by the time I got to the half one, my coach got on, Coach Lambright got on like the 30th floor. And he was drunk as a skunk. I'm like, oh, Coach.
Y'all was doing way too much, Ron.
He's looking at me like, good one, I'm going to eat your butt up next year. Well, you know, it's all celebration, man. When some guys, you know, when you go to war with, and you guys all get on the same page, the coaches, the fans, the players, it's a beautiful thing, the city. It's nothing like it. So enjoy this moment.
Yes, sir. You enjoy know, life.
Enjoy period. Life, period. Yeah, thank you, Breeze.
Enjoy life, period.
Enjoy life,
and
period.
And you know what? One important thing I was thinking of today, I was like, you know what? Don't expect anything from anybody, and then you won't be let down.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying? So if you expect somebody to do something, and they don't do it, you're going to get let down. If you go through life not expecting somebody to do something or anything like that, then you won't, there's nothing to be looked down upon, you know, you won't be let down.
Amen.
So, you gotta go after everything, don't expect somebody to give it to you, you know, nobody gives away nothing, you gotta go out there and get it, you know what I'm saying?
Fight for it, boy.
You know?
And don't give up, you know, you guys, it's never over, like the young, just to touch on some things that's going on concurrent right now, just because everything's been down, let's talk about the positive things real quick. Like about the young man on the 49ers, who was cut from so many teams. This man goes in 2 weeks ago and broke a record that was 260 yards. He beat somebody's record. I want to say Jim Brown. No, Earl Campbell's. So, you young athletes out there, man, men and females, Don't let nobody tell you. You get cut from some from whatever, man. You keep fighting because there's going to be a team, and not to knock the teams that cut him. Maybe the system didn't fit where the system he was in didn't fit him. Like the coach said, this system fit him with the 49ers. The rest is history. The man is on his way to get some hardware. So keep your eye on the prize. DJ Nice here, DJ Breeze.
Hey,
what's up, bro?
Y'all got a fan in here? I need some water or something, man. I need...
It's
kind of hot up in here, bro.
Yeah.
Hey, but until then, we'll keep spinning in the mix, bro.
Yeah, we'll get back in here. I'm gonna give DJ Breeze some. He's a little parched.
Wait, I need a piece of water. Paper. Maybe I could just fan myself or something. Maybe that might just happen.
DJ you know Nice, DJ Breeze.
Some aerobics or something. You know what I'm saying? Cool my body down.
Get down and give me 50. But give me 50.
Let's get back in the mix, pimp.
DJ Nice.
Yes, sir.
DJ Breeze here in the traffic mix. God bless you guys.
DJ J Nice down here at San Jose College in the mix for your traffic jam pleasures. Once again, drive safe. Go Niners. DJ Breezel in the mix.
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed the show. We're almost out of here, man. First of all, thank you, DJ Jeff. Thank you, Miss G, for blessing me with this extra hour. I know I probably earned it, but I'm feeling so blessed right now just to be blessed to have my 2 hours. I mean, just if you guys would say, Jay Nice, we're going to give you 1 hour and 5 minutes. I am blessed. And I thank you guys so much, Miss G and DJ Jeff. You guys are so awesome. And I don't know what I would do without my KJC family. So now we'll get back into the mix, you guys. We're going to take you guys to that next phase. I hope you guys are... Now, traffic should be winding down now. Other than a couple of congested spots around our 280 where there's always problems. You know, that Los Gatos area. But even so, take that time in traffic to reflect on how you're going home to your loved ones. Okay? And hope you guys enjoyed our show. But it's not over yet. We still got 35, 45 minutes. All right, DJ Nice and DJ Breeze.
Yes, sir.
Traffic Mix. KJCC 104.1.
This is when you talk from the song.
I'm messing with you. Yo, I just want to say, really, I ain't got nothing to say. I've been kind of down in the dumps.
Me too.
I'm gonna tell you, yeah, I do got something to say, matter of fact. Be careful what kind of insurance you got, because if you have uninsured motorists, right, and you get hit by a hit-and-run driver, they will not pay for your vehicle until they find a hit-and-run driver to prove that the hit-and-run driver don't have insurance. Ain't that something, bro?
I didn't know that.
Yes, California law. So,
PSA.
So just so you know, I got hit and run by a driver DJing in South Lake Tahoe.
Again.
Okay, again. They have the person on film, right? I called my insurance company. I don't want to say their name, but it starts with a G, and they got a lizard on the commercial or whatever. It's on the commercial. I don't even know what it is. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, so yeah, uninsured motorist does not cover a hit and run until they find the person that hit and runs you to prove that they don't have insurance. Ain't that something?
You know what, Breeze? This is crazy. That's messed up. I'm working with Progressive. I'm in the same situation. I was in an Uber car.
Man.
Went to a video shoot. And then I got hit. I'm just now getting the money that's owed to me,
man.
3 years later.
I told the insurance company, I said, what am I paying for then? What am I actually paying for? You know what I'm saying? So now I got to switch and get collision and comprehensive, because that'll cover me all the way.
Oh, right,
and then,
right.
Of course, you want to get roadside in case you get stuck somewhere.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? But you got to be careful on the insurance you get. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes people want to get the cheapest insurance, but sometimes the cheapest insurance ain't the best insurance.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? That's for really, PSA. Really, really, though. You know what I'm saying?
That was a PSA you just did again. But, Breeze, that is so true, man. I think what we need to do is get a tour bus. Because this my man, he's been hitting his travel truck for his equipment, where because he's a busy man. This man is one of the hardest working DJs in west of the Mississippi. So,
I do be traveling, putting some miles on my feet and my vehicle, you know what I'm saying?
Be getting it in.
Right, DJ, I want a chicken sponsor, though. Can I get a chicken sponsor?
I'm still hungry from that last episode. We're talking about chicken. Yeah, who could afford us though? KFC.
No. I don't want no KFC though. I want like a mom and pop somewhere that I can blow up. That's good. They got a lot of them, but I like to spend my money with the local businesses.
Okay.
The community businesses. Absolutely. I don't like to spend my money with the major names.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? The mom and pops.
Corporates.
The mom and pops. They show me love and respect when mm-hmm. I go in the store. The man at the liquor store, he love me, okay? Mm-hmm. I'm in there, I'm supporting him.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I come in there 2 or 3 times a day. You know what I'm saying? I'm not in there buying alcohol, but I'm in there 3 or 4 times a day. You
right.
know what I'm saying? I should buy some stock in Swisher Sweet, but we'll just keep it like that there. You know what I'm saying?
You want big Swisher yourself.
Yeah,
okay.
I want big Swisher myself. Diamond Swisher. Right now, baby.
Hey, you know how's the manor going? How's the manor going?
Manor's going good. New owner over there.
Beautiful, Melissa. Hi, Melissa.
You know what I'm saying? I'm doing the manor. I'm also I work with this guy named Matt. He's a really good dude. I worked with him for like 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
He owns he's part owner or owns, I don't know, it's all his business, but the Kickin' Mule in Danville. I'll be DJing there this Saturday night. There's also
drop where you're gonna be DJing. Give me a list so everybody can
yeah, yeah. There. I'll give you a little rundown right now. So Thursday night I'm gonna be at the Manor, which is in San Lorenzo. I'm gonna have California Fancy Dog outside with the hot dogs so everybody can get their eat on, get their drink on. A little dartboard in there, a little pool table. You know, it's a little small bar.
Beautiful bartender.
You know what I'm saying? Beautiful bartender.
Lexi and Melissa.
Yes, they go to the gym, yes. Okay, and then I'll also be out there at Danville, Chicken Mule, with my girl Gina serving up the drinks. You know what I'm saying? It's going down out there. We be in a mix. You know what I'm saying? And then that's about it. You know what I'm saying?
Keeping busy, DJ. I see you.
Yeah, and then I'm waiting to see what happens for the summer. But like I said, back to my buddy Matt. He also, like, Kickin' Mule, Sacramento, Kickin' Mule, Danville. We got Pick 6, South Lake Tahoe, where I just got back from.
Amen.
And then Pick 6 in Pleasanton. You know what I'm saying? And he's got a couple other things that he's got his feet on and hands in, and I'm right there with him. We riding through. So
he's got the Pick 6 in Danville and the one out there in Tahoe.
Tahoe and Pleasanton, yeah.
Go ahead, Pick 6, doing it big.
You
don't forget about your boy Jay Nice. I sing and I play piano.
You know what I'm saying?
No, that's fantastic, Breeze. I just want to say hi to my mom, my beautiful mother. She's had a rough week. We've all had a rough week. She lost a close friend to her. My mom's a former teacher in Oakland Public Schools. If you guys in Oakland and San Leandro area, if you guys know, there was a teacher that was killed in a crosswalk last week. That was my mother's friend and dear friend. So my mom's at the funeral tonight, and I hope she's keeping her head up. I'll see you, Mom, when I get home. And my little brother, if you could put my prayers in for my brother, Curtis Goodwin, is going to surgery. I love you, Curtis, the baseball coach out there in Florida who's coaching Little League, or future baseball stars. Keep your head up, Curtis. You've made it. We made it. The good ones made it to worse more. Way worse more. So you can make it through this. Love my Goodwin family. I love my son. I hope you're out there working on your golf swing, PGA. My son's been PGA certified since he was 16. So I hope you're working on winning a Masters, okay? We got Rose Bowl rings. We need a Masters in the house, okay? Love you, son. I hope my daughter with Adidas, she's doing the big things over there in administration. Big, big things. So proud of her. My son Jacob and Thomas, hope you're doing good, son. Getting ready for football for next year. And my who else? If I didn't mention you, my agent, Angela Wright, and FMB. Let's work a little harder. Let's get me somewhere.
Get on them. Okay. Get on their helmet. You know what I'm saying? That's the only way you got to get on them is get on their helmet. DJ Breezel, we in the house, in the mix, doing what we do. Hey, you know what? I want to say one last thing.
Please do.
He said, please do. He's probably like, boy,
I got you back.
You got me back. Fired on me. Hey, doesn't Christmas feel like it's a deadline instead of like a celebration? Doesn't it like the whole month of December feel like a deadline?
Yeah.
Like Christmas is a deadline, the
yes,
last
it is.
Days?
Yeah.
It's not like... It's not like a celebration no more. It's like a deadline.
Like a deadline.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's like Christmas Day is the deadline. You know what I'm saying? People, they ain't paying their car payments. They ain't, I mean, just, I don't even know why I'm talking about
I was thinking
Christmas.
The same. No, Breeze, no. Now that it's the storm is over with the holidays, I think the same way, man, because I'm older now. People put so much into the money cost of getting a gift to somebody. Instead of just...
And some people are upset if they don't get an expensive gift. If somebody else gets more expensive gifts than the other person, then, you know, people get hurt, and it shouldn't be like that. You know what I'm saying?
We lose focus on what it's really about.
Really, though. Really, though. And then I'm not with, you know what I'm saying? When I was little, yes, I believed in Santa Claus. You know what I'm saying? A lot of parents say, oh, I want the kids to know where it came from. You know, don't kill they don't Absolutely, kill yes. don't kill the dream, right. the fantasy,
right.
you know, the tooth fairy, whatever. Not even though you know what's going on, the kids still some kids still believe in certain things,
and they deserve that.
Don't ruin it because you want to be an adult and maybe you are kind of bitter or something. I don't know, maybe something happened to you.
Breeze.
You know what I'm saying? That's real.
I'm glad you touched on it, man. A lot of kids are they're losing their innocence too early. Let's go back. Let's challenge each other, 2020, to get back to get. Let's put the kids first.
Right, make them go outside and play. Turn the PS3 off.
Let's put the kids first. Let's start doing that again. Remember back in the 70s and the 80s in our old-fashioned days when we didn't have our pants sagging, when we actually had... We were old-fashioned, but old-fashioned was cool for me.
You know, actually, you know...
I'm good with old-fashioned.
The pants sagging actually came from jail, meaning invitation.
Yeah, yeah.
So, y'all out here with this pants sagging, you got a big old invitation hanging back there. That's what it really means. It's not symbolizing gangster. It doesn't make you look cool. You actually don't. You look like a fool. That's what
right.
you look like.
That's Ray Breeze.
And if you get in a fight or something, you got to pull up your pants about 300 times. And by that time, you might have got socked about 400 times.
It's
so, you
late.
Know, sagging the pants, that's not, there's nothing gangster cool about that.
Nothing cool about it. And again, me and Breeze want to let you know, there's nothing cool about putting your hands on anybody. We do not
right.
like domestic violence.
Right.
Take the 10-second challenge. It's better to have that time. You take that 10 seconds, I guarantee you it's going to work out.
If you're a Gemini, you got to take like about a 25-second to 20-second timeout.
Whatever.
We got flash statuses.
Whatever it takes, you know. No, absolutely, Breeze. But whatever it takes for 10, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, take that time to relax and walk away from the situation so you could talk it out and walk it out. So that's our thing right here. No more domestic violence. No more hitting. Love shouldn't hurt. Okay.
Go eat a piece of chicken.
Or bring a bucket of chicken to me and Breeze.
Man, I wouldn't trust somebody bringing me some chicken right now. I don't even trust them. What do you call them drivers? Bring your food. Uber Eats.
I
wouldn't trust an Uber Eats.
I heard
he might be wiping his feet on my hamburger before it gets there or something.
No.
I don't know. Eating my fries. He might have took some of my shake or something. And, you know, I'm just saying, I can't. I'm looking. Have you seen some of the Uber Eats drivers that show up?
No.
Man, I had one show up look like he needed some lotion on his feet.
Oh, my God.
Crusty hands.
Here we go.
Can I get a tip? No.
I just lost my appetite, y'all.
Yeah, call Uber Eats. You might lose your appetite. Can we get back to the mix so I can get some chicken later on?
I'm not calling Uber Eats.
No, don't call Uber Eats.
DJ Nights here, DJ Breeze.
I think that's what they call me, DJ Breeze Ale, right?
DJ Brazil. Oh, here we are. We're going to jump back into the rest of the mix that's left of it. God bless you guys, and we're glad you guys are giving you guys your 2 hours. We know you guys could be anywhere else, but you chose to spend 2 hours with us. Thank you. KJCC Live, DJ Nice, and Bleed.
Yes, sir.
Traffic mix.
Tonight's the night. Tonight, brown liquor love, baby, all night. Tonight's the night. Tonight. Sex, texting on the late night. Full of that brown. Naughty thoughts, whoever hits me back is going down.